Hello and welcome to the course Manufacturing Method. So this is the new semester, so new course has been started. I am Somobroto Chakraborty and I am going to teach you about manufacturing methods. I am going to take this subject manufacturing method. So I will deliver you lecture on this course. So today for module 1 lecture 1 introduction to manufacturing. So we will start by knowing the learning objective. The lecture objectives are to understand the meaning of manufacturing. This is the first lecture objective. Next manufacturing. The next one is to identify clear difference between the term production and manufacturing. The identification of the difference between production and manufacturing. Next, to analyze the chronological development of manufacturing method. Fourth one is to classify the manufacturing method in a clear manner. So we will study this lecture for these four main objectives. So first, the term manufacturing. This word came from the Latin word manufactus. By manufacture means made by hand. So anything that can be made by hand is known as manufacturing. In engineering definition, the manufacturing can be written as or can be treated as a process. Manufacturing is a process of value addition to raw material for desired shape and size and function. So what is important? Desired shape, size and function. This is important. So from raw material, we will have the finished product. Finished product means the object with the desired shape, size and function are known as finished product. Say, for example, we have raw material such as wood. We have raw material wood. So from wood we want the finished product. What we desire? We desire from wood we will get a table. This is our desire. So from wood we desire for a table. If we are getting a table by any process, by some process, this table is our finished product. But if from wood when we desire, this table is our desired product or finished product. But if we get in the place of table, if we get a chair, then chair is not our desired product. So from wood, if we are getting chair as a finished product, then there should be a fault in our manufacturing process or in our value addition process. Do you have the clear idea about raw material? So what is raw material? Anything that need to be developed for being functional, or that, such as wood. Wood cannot be used simply. So for that we need to add some value. By adding some value we can make chair, table, anything we want. So if we desire for a table and we are getting a table, then table is called the finished product. What object with desired shape, size and function is known as finished product. So if we desire for table, then our finished product is table. And if we are getting a chair, then there is some fault in our manufacturing, in our value addition process or manufacturing process. So now from this raw material to finished product, means from wood to table, this can be achieved by more than one ways. So conversion from raw material to finished product can be done in many ways, and all of them can be treated as individual manufacturing method. So all of them can be treated as engineering manufacturing method. That means all of this raw material, these processes, this is a process step, this is process one, this is process two. There can be various other process also. See, this is process three, or many more. So all these processes are getting to the from raw material to finished product. When in every process where we are getting the finished product as desired, then these various value addition processes are known as manufacturing. Okay, now another thing is important here. See, their manufacturing can be done in one step, or it can be done more than one step. So in case of more than one step, the finished product of one process can be the raw material for the next process. Okay, see here, so this is the raw material. From here, an intermediate finished product is formed, and after that we got the finished product. See, for example, we can see this by an example. See, if we desire for a duster, so a simple duster has two components. First one is, this is the wooden part of the duster, blackboard duster, and there is a spongy part of the blackboard duster, and both these two, see, I will draw it correctly. So first, there is a wooden part of the duster. This is the wooden part of the duster. So our finished product is duster, and raw materials are wood and sponge. So this is the wooden part, and now this is our spongy part. So now both these two parts, these two sponge and wooden part, these two parts are first made from wood. The sponge part is made from wood, the wooden part is made, and from the sponge, this spongy part is made. And after that, these two are our intermediate finished product. Now if we have to get our finished product, we have to join this. So these two, this wooden part and this spongy part, these two are the raw material, are the finished product of one process. That is, these two are the finished product of one process, but it is the raw material of the second process, that is joining process. By joining them together, we'll get a complete duster. Okay, by joining that, we will get a complete duster. So this is the process, this is the main thing of the manufacturing process. So from raw material we add some value, we add some value. So the value addition process is known as manufacturing process. So now we will see the difference between manufacturing and production. Okay, in case of manufacturing, it is a value addition process to tangible raw material, to tangible raw material. Now see, tangible means can be touched. So tangible means can be touched. So when the raw material is tangible, then the product is also tangible. Finished or semi-finished product is also tangible. This is known as manufacturing. But in case of production, it is the broader aspect of manufacturing. In case of production, the value addition is to tangible as well as non-tangible. Non-tangible means can't be felt by, can't be touched. Okay. That means can't be so. That means can't be touched. Non-tangible means can't be touched. So now, from this, we can say that production, for example, an automobile camshaft can be manufactured, but in case of film or a software, that can be produced. So, as a summary, we can say that production has the broader aspect, and in between which, there is one term, one particular case of tangible, particular case of tangible raw material and tangible finished product, where finished product is known as manufacturing. So manufacturing is a part of production. So manufacturing, it is a part of part of production. Okay, it is a part of production. So now it is a part of production. So we will see now the chronological development of manufacturing process. Chronological development means, this chronological means the development with time. Okay, this chronological means development with time. So we will see the development with time. When the early age, the oldest and the simplest form of the manufacturing is, oldest and the simplest form of the manufacturing is casting. In casting, what happened? Casting is a process of pouring molten material to the cavity, and when the molten material is solidified, then that material takes the shape of the cavity. This process is known as casting. So casting means pouring molten material, and upon solidification, they take the shape of the cavity. This is the casting. So it is practiced in the early age of humankind. From there, it is practiced till now. But there is some modification. The thing is that the first and oldest and the simplest method of manufacturing is casting. So in casting, automobile component, pipe, railroad, toys and ornaments, this can be produced. And this is a pictorial view of the, there is a pictorial view of the casting process, in which the molten material poured into these cavities to get the shape of that cavity. The casting is very important for single or one piece product, and it is been used from the early age of the humankind. Next, after the casting, that can manufacture single product, there is need of modification on the product. So that modification on the product can be done using bulk deformation. That modification can be done using bulk deformation, and that bulk deformation can be achieved by a process called metal forming process. In metal forming, what happens? The product from casting, such as slab, billet, blooms, are product from the casting can be modified to finished product. So what are the difference between product from the casting, such as slab, billets and bloom? Slab, billets and bloom, these are classified on the basis of their dimension. So where slab has 3000 mm wide and 320 mm thick, maximum dimension. These are the maximum dimension. What is this? These are the maximum dimension. So these are the maximum dimension. So in case of bloom, it can be either square or rectangular, but maximum dimension is 500 mm. The maximum dimension is 500 mm. And billets are the square cross section with 180 mm side. Square cross section with 180 mm side. From this casting product, we can modify them to. It can be modified by using metal forming process to weld, to wire, rod, angles, etc. So the major metal forming processes are forging. Major metal forming processes are forging, rolling, extrusion, drawing, and sheet metal operation. Detail of this operation will be taught in this course only as the course proceeds. So we will discuss in detail about the forging, rolling, extrusion, drawing and sheet metal operation. After here, I am giving you the overview how the manufacturing process is developed. So first, the casting is developed. After casting, there is a need of metal modification. There is need of modification of the casting part. So that can be done using metal forming. After metal forming, it is up to here only single piece object is used. For after metal forming, for better functionability, there is a need for manufacturing by loose part and joining it using material joining processes. One of the material joining processes is known as welding, which is a process of joining similar or dissimilar material with or without application of heat, pressure and filler material. So now how the development is going on? First there is casting, then after that there is metal forming. In casting, what happened? In casting, by molten material, we got a shape. That shape is the similar to the shape of that cavity. From that we can modify the casted part by bulk deformation using metal forming process. Now we have two metal forming modified part that can be joined using the welding process. So joining is important for better functionability. So joining is important for what? For better functionability. And welding is a process where we can have the joining of similar or dissimilar material with or without application of heat, pressure and filler material. So what is welding? Welding is a process in which joining of similar or dissimilar material with or without application of heat, pressure and filler material can be done. So in automobile body grills, that can be grill that is used in windows or any other places that can be done using the welding process. So this is a pictorial view of this is a pictorial view of the welding. This is a pictorial view of the welding process. And now after we got the welding process, then there is a need of removal of material by which we can have the desired shape by the removal of the material. So joining process is as the joining process is developed, need for cutting the material to desired shape is emerging. So that emerging need lead us to the development of the metal cutting or machining process. So this machining process are developed after the welding process. This machining process has been developed. So now this machining processes are, what is machining process? Machining process, it is a process in which raw material is shaped to desired shape using a wedge shape cutter. Wedge shape cutter means the cutter will have this type of pointed edge. This pointed edge is known as wedge shaped. This known as wedge shaped cutter. So this wedge shaped cutter is known as cutting tool. In a machine tool, and the material is removed in the form of chips. So total definition of the machining will be, it is a process in which raw material is shaped to desired shape using a wedge shaped cutter known as cutting tool in a machine tool, and the material is removed from the chip, removed in the form of chip. The detailed discussion of this, what is the wedge meaning of wedge shape, the cutting tool, machine tool, this will be discussed on the respective chapter of this subject only. And right now, it is just for your overview about the chronological development, about the development of the manufacturing process, how the manufacturing process is developed and how it is developing even now. So there is some of the example of the machining process are drilling, turning, drilling, milling, shaping, slot cutting, etc. And there is many more, but these are the some of the machining or metal cutting processes. So this is the pictorial view of the metal cutting process. It is a facing operation. It is a turning operation in which this point is a wedge shaped cutting tool, and the machine where the operation is going on is known as lathe, or it is a machine tool, and this is the workpiece. So this is machining process. After machining or up to machining, this four process, that means that casting, forging or casting, metal forming, welding and cutting, welding and metal cutting, these are known as conventional process. After the conventional process, there is development in each and every field of the manufacturing process, in all the field of the manufacturing. So in this development, non-conventional machining is developed. This non-conventional machining differs from the conventional machining in the form of in non-conventional machining, in most cases there is no chip formation, there is no wedge shape tool used, but the material is removed on the basis of natural properties such as vibration, abrasion, electrochemical electrolysis, electric discharge, लेजर बीम और इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम. सो दिस बाय यूजिंग दिस नेचुरल प्रॉपर्टीज बाय यूजिंग दिस नेचुरल फिजिक्स प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द फिजिक्स वी कैन डेवलप we develop some of the material removal process. Those are known as non-conventional machining. In them, some importance are ultrasonic machining. Here, ultrasonic vibration is used for material removal. In abrasive jet machining, the high-speed blasting of the abrasive particle on the material is used to remove the material. In electrochemical machining, electrolysis is used. In laser beam machining, high power density laser beam is used. And in electron beam machining, high speed electron beam is used to remove the material. Now, for another kind of development is done in the field of machining, that is called numeric control or computer numeric control. In conventional case, the process parameter of the machining, such as the process parameter of the machining, that means speed of the machining and the operation of the machining, is controlled using the operator. So operator skill is a variable thing, and this operator skill is operator is human, and humans are prone to error. To minimize this error and to get maximum production rate, to get more production rate, numeric control is introduced. In numeric control, there is some punch card with set of instruction that can be fed into the machine or machine tool. In numeric control, there is also, though there is some problem. So for that, the main problem with numeric control is, if you want to change some instruction in between in the time of the operation, you can't do it. You have to change whole set of instruction. But in case of computer numeric control, you have the advantage of changing small part of the instruction whenever you want. So in computer numeric control, you feed the desired shape of the object to the machine, and that machine will produce fully automatically by computer control or computer numeric control to the finished product is developed. So these are the development in the field of machining, so for the better performance in metal cutting. Now after this development, there is another type of development. So due to every day there is high amount of chip is formed in whole world, and these chips are a waste material. So for minimizing the material loss or for having zero or low material loss, regenerative process such as 3D printing and rapid prototyping has been developed. After the development of 3D printing and rapid prototyping, which is still in research, they are being developed day by day right now. And alongside of this, hybrid machining are in trend. Hybrid machining means the combination of two or more machining processes together to getting the advantage of both the processes. For example, in case of abrasive water jet machining, the advantage of high speed water jet and high speed abrasive jet are merged together to have more material removal. Next, in case of electrochemical grinding, the grinding is merged with the electrolysis process, which gives more production rate, higher accuracy. Okay, so This is how the chronologically the manufacturing process is developed. For a summary, we can say, that the manufacturing process is still developing. But as if we want to say the how the development has been done, so that can be understood using this diagram. Say from casting to metal forming, then welding, machining, non-conventional machining, numeric control, CNC, 3D printing, and hybrid machining. This process is going on, and the manufacturing process is the backbone of the civilization, because due to this manufacturing processes, due to development and research in this manufacturing processes, we can achieve our desire, that is high production rate. Good quality. Good quality and low cost. So what this is our desire? We want our daily object. We want our daily object to be high production rate, to meet the higher demand, and quality should be good, and the cost should be low. So for these three motto, the development in the manufacturing, in all the fields of manufacturing, process are going on, and this development leads us to the better sustainable future. So the main important thing here is from the beginning of the civilization, manufacturing is there, and that manufacturing is developed as per demand, as per need. Right now, this is the age of 3D printing, or this is the age of regenerative process. So 3D printing and hybrid machining, these are in trend nowadays. But each and every process is equally important for understanding the manufacturing process and for understanding this subject. So now we will see the classification of the manufacturing method. The manufacturing method is classified in four main broader way, that is shaping and forming, removal process, joining process, and regenerative process. So in shaping and forming, some shape or form can be done, that is further divided into casting, injection molding, next is forging, rolling, extrusion or drawing, and powder metallurgical process. And regenerative process is further divided into stereolithography, selective sintering, laminated object manufacturing, and fused deposition modeling. Now we will see that for shaping or forming, shaping or forming means manufacturing a solid product of definite size and shape from a given material that taken in three possible states. So if the raw material, so the thing is that shaping and or forming, that means a solid product of definite shape and size can be formed. Using the given material, even using the given raw material in three stages. If the raw material in solid state, then the operations are forging, rolling, extrusion and drawing, etc. if the material, raw materials are in liquid or semi-liquid state, then the processes are casting, injection molding, etc. And if they are in powder form, the process will be powder metallurgical process. Now, next is joining process. The example of joining process is welding, brazing, and soldering. We will discuss all these processes. We will discuss all these processes in detail later on. Now, right now, I am giving only the classification of the manufacturing process. So now, nextly, removal processes. In material removal processes, there is machining. Machining can be traditional or non-traditional, that means conventional or non-conventional type of machining, and there is grinding and many more. And that there is regenerative process. In regenerative process, this regenerative process are in trend nowadays. This is the production of solid products in layer by layer from raw material in different form. If the raw materials are of liquid, then the process is known as stereolithography. If the raw materials are in powder form, then the process is known as selective sintering. If the raw materials are in sheet form, then the process is known as laminated object manufacturing or LOM. And if the raw materials are in wear form, then the process is known as fused deposition modeling or FDM. So these are the classification of the manufacturing process. So I guess you enjoy the courses or enjoy the lecture. Please let me know if you have any problem. Thank you.